Hello students, this is Purvi. Today we are going to discuss about the fifth chapter from Indian Economic Development, Economics, that is Human Resource Formation in India. Human capital refers to the stock of skill, ability, expertise, education and knowledge in a nation at a point of time, while physical capital refers to assets which themselves have been manufactured and are used for production of other goods and services. Let us discuss about the physical capital versus human capital. Physical capital is tangible, while human capital is intangible. Physical capital is separable from its owners, while human capital cannot be separated from its owners. Physical capital is perfectly mobile between the countries, while human capital does not have mobility as it is restricted by nationality and culture. Physical capital depreciates over time due to constant use or due to change in technology, while human capital depreciates with aging but can be made up through continuous investment in education and health. Physical capital creates only private benefit, while human capital creates private benefit as well as social benefit. Human capital formation. Human capital formation is the process of adding to the stock of human capital over a period of time. Various sources of human capital formation are expenditure on education, expenditure on health, on the job training, study programs for adults, migration and expenditure on information. Human resource development. Now, human resource development refers to the development of the set of individuals that makes up the workforce of an organization, business sector or economy. Various roles of human resource development include raising production, changing emotional and physical environment of growth, improvising the quality of life, raising life expectancy, innovating skills, and raising social justice and equality. Now, what are the various problems that are faced by human resource development? The problems that are faced by human resource development are rising population, high regional and gender inequality, brain drain, insufficient manpower planning, insufficient on-the-job training in agriculture, high poverty levels, and low academic standards. Education. It implies the process of teaching, training, and learning, especially in schools, colleges, to improve knowledge and develop skills. Now, what are the various importance or objectives of education? Education produces good citizens. It facilitates use of resources in the country. Also helps to develop science and technology. It expands mental horizon of people, promotes cultural standard of the citizens, and develops human personality. Now, what are the various problems relating to development of education in India? Education in India is being challenged by various numbers of factors like large number of illiterates, inadequate vocationalization, gender biasness, low rural access level and low government expenditure on education. Because of all these factors, the development of education in India is becoming more and more challenging. Human capital formation in India. Now, the 7th 5-year plan is stressed upon the importance of human capital. In India, Ministry of Education at the center and state level, NCERT, UGC, AICTE regulate the education sector? In India, Ministry of Health at the union and the state level and ICMR regulate the health sector. World Bank states that India will become the knowledge economy. Also, if India uses its knowledge as much as Ireland does, then the per capita income will rise by $3,000 by the year of 2020. Interrelationship between human capital formation and economic growth. Human capital formation raises the process of economic growth, and economic growth raises the process of human capital formation. Let us see how does they are interdependent. Now, rise in human capital raise economic growth. Rise in human capital gives rise to modern attitude and outlook, better quality of life, higher life expectancy, which ultimately gives rise in more efficiency and gives increase in production, therefore leading to economic growth. Rise in economic growth raises human capital formation. Now, a significant rise in economic growth gives rise in per capita income, which would lead us to more investment in education and health, ultimately giving rise in human capital. Education sector in India. The first is elementary education. Now, elementary education covers students from class 1 to class 8 in the age group of 6 to 14 years. The number of primary and middle schools has considerably increased from 2.23 lakhs to 11.92 lakhs from the year 1950-51 to 2011-12. Near about 97% children in the age group of 6 to 14 years have been receiving education in schools. Various policies such as Sarva Siksha Abhiyan, Midday Meal Scheme, District Primary Education Program, Right to Education have been playing major role in enhancing primary education in India. Second is secondary and senior secondary education. As per a survey, number of secondary and senior secondary schools rose to 2.12 lakhs and number of students getting education at this level rose up to 482 lakhs. At central level, Navodaya schools and Kendriya Vidyalayas are playing a vital role in promoting education at this level. The third is higher education. As per a survey in India, near about 665 universities are imparting education at higher level and number of colleges imparting general education is 35,829. Number of students getting higher education is about 130 lakhs. In addition to it, since independence, the number of institutions imparting technical and professional education has increased significantly in India, in which polytechnical institutions, engineering colleges, medical colleges, research centers like IIT, Agriculture Research Institute, India Statistical Institute, IIM, etc. are playing prominent roles. So students, this was the fifth chapter from Economics book, Indian Economic Development. Thank you.